Hi friends, in this video I'm going to talk about how many companies are using microservices. What is a monolithic one? What's the difference between monolithic and microservice? Why companies are migrating towards microservices? Let's see. First of all, what is the monolithic architecture? It has a single code base. For example, you can see here the single product has a user interface, business logic, and data interface. So in a single system, multiple modules will be packed and will be running. Most probably it'll have a single database. So what are the challenges of monolithic architecture? Since a single product has multiple modules, so they are tightly coupled and less reusability, and they are less scalable, and they don't follow single responsibility principle. They require multiple deployments and restart times. For example, if your business is growing and traffic is growing, your architecture cannot scale. These are the challenges for monolithic architecture. A microservice architecture is a method of developing software applications which are independently deployable modular services, and they have their own database. So one of the main benefits of microservice architecture is it has improved scalability. So when the traffic is growing, you can perform the auto scaling for your product. And the next benefit of microservice architecture is technology agnostic. Say you have multiple microservices, and for each microservice, you can choose the technology stack. You don't have to stick to one programming language, but based on your need, you can choose your technology stack. That's why it is technology agnostic. The next advantage for microservice architecture is faster time to market. Since in microservice architecture, the components are independent and independently we can deploy, we don't have to wait for other components to be ready. Once the feature is ready in one of the microservices, we can reach the market very fast. So these are the few differences between monolithic architecture and microservice architecture. Now let's see some statistics. The statistics says that 68% of the company currently using microservices in production and development. And the next survey is 36% of large companies and 50% of medium companies and 44% of small companies are using the microservice architecture in production and development. And finally, 26% of the companies are still researching about microservice architecture but not yet implemented them. An interesting fact is that when the companies have been moved to microservices, it's been observed that 13 times frequency of software release has been increased. For example, if a company is releasing one release per day, after moving to microservice architecture, they start releasing 13 releases per day. Hi friends, hope this small information about microservice architecture is useful. Please subscribe to my channel, and all the best for your career. Thank you.